This tutorial shows how to conduct the one sample Wilcoxon signed rank test and interpret the results in R. Its aim is to compare the sample median and a hypothesized median or population median for differences. Let's quickly talk requirements. The dependent variable or test variable should be at least on the ordinal scale. If a metric variable lacks an approximate normal distribution, the one sample Wilcoxon test is commonly used in favor of the one sample t-test. My calculation example consists of 51 people being asked for their age, and I want to see whether the observed median differs from a hypothesized median of 30. As a first step after importing data, I want to see the median age for my sample using the median function. It is 36 and an indication that it might be different, statistically significant speaking, from the hypothesized median of 30. For this, I use the wilcox.test function and start off with the test variable. After that, I use mu equals 30 to test my sample median against the population median of 30. Note that the default testing will be two-sided, meaning you test only for a difference. In case you proposed in advance that your sample median is larger than the population median, you can add the argument alternative equals greater, meaning your sample median is greater than the population median. If you, however, hypothesized a smaller sample median, you use alternative equals less. Note, if you need confidence intervals for reporting, you can request them with conf.int equals true. And a final note, the calculation of the p-value will be exact by default. This will, however, fail if you have ties, meaning at least one value has a count of at least two. Set the argument exact equals false if this is the case. I can run this one line and get the results. If the p-value is below the predefined threshold, for example 0.05, the null hypothesis can be rejected. Reminder, the null hypothesis assumes no difference between sample median and proposed population median. In my case, I defined alpha as 0.05 and can therefore reject the null hypothesis because my p-value for a two-sided test is 4.95 times 10 to the negative 10. The difference between my sample median and the population median is therefore statistically significant. Please note that the pseudo-median shown here differs from the calculated median in case you have a skewed distribution. No worries though, you can ignore the pseudo-median in almost all cases. Finally, if I tested one-sided for a larger sample median than population median, I could certainly see a significant result as well, because the two-sided p-value is halved. After a significant one-sample Wilcoxon test, the effect size should be calculated, which is shown in the following video.